Well, sir, I come upon this great big round building, and there was a sign on it in neon lights that said, "Hockey here tonight." Well, I said to myself, by granny, I'm going to get in on this. And there's a whole bunch of people standing in line there. There's all wanting to go. So I fell in line, and I got up this little window, and he said, "That'll be a dollar and a half, please." I says, "What fair?" And he said, "For hockey." That kind of throwed me. I says, "Ain't that a little high?" And he says, "No, there's some of them pays more than that." I says, "Well, I guess some of them wants to go worse than others." He says, "Yeah, and they get better seats, too." Well, sir, I got in there, and I sat down, and you won't believe this, but there's thousands of people around in a great big circle, and right down in the middle of this big building was a pond, and it is all froze over, solid ice. And there's a bunch of fellers out there on it scooting around, had runners on their shoes. And all at once, there's a feller in a striped shirt come out in the middle of it, blowed a whistle, and everybody gathered around, and it got awful quiet. And I says to myself, something's going to happen right now. And this feller in the striped shirt had a little round thing in his hand. It is about the size of a mason's fruit jar lid. And I said to this feller sitting next to me, I said, "What is that down there?" And he said, "It's hockey." And about that time, he dropped it, and I don't blame him. Because he jumped back, and these fellas made a run at that thing, and it caused awfulest fracas ever you seen in your life. I mean, there's a knocking at it, them sticks, you know, and I finally figured out what they was doing. They was trying to get it off of the ice so they could skate. That thing would trip them up, you know. Liable to fall and break their contract. And finally, they decided that they'd knock it in one of them baskets located on each end of the pond, about a 5-bushel basket. But they couldn't make up their minds which one they wanted to put it in. And to top that, there's two fellers standing in front of the basket, and I reckon they owned them. Because they said, I'll tell you one thing, you ended up putting her in my basket. And they was down there scuffling around over that thing and right in front of this feller's basket, and he turned his head for 1 second and in it went. I was kind of glad. I says, "Well, maybe they can go ahead and do whatever it was they come here to do in the first place." About that time, old Smarty, the one in the striped shirt, he come running out there and grabbed that thing and throwed it down and started the whole darn thing over again. And I said, this feller sitting next to me, I says, "Well, why don't one of them just reach down there and grab that thing, throw it out in the backyard, and get it over with?" He says, "Well, they can't do that." I says, "Why?" He says, "They got to use their hockey sticks." Well, you can understand that. Thing went on for, I'd say, two hours or more, and they never did get that thing off of the ice. And I still don't know what happened. But I can tell you this, friends, if you're ever downtown, you got a dollar and a quarter on you, and you see a sign that says hockey here tonight, you get in there and try it.